they love by launching a site that's free to start with room to grow. Their customer support team is made of actual WordPress experts who are standing by to help you 24 hours a day, including weekends. And WordPress users own their content forever. Get 15% off any new plan purchase at wordpress.com/thedaily.
Okay, so what does the Trump administration actually do with this ruling from Chief Justice Roberts?
Well, now, Michael, the chaos starts.
The U.S. government will print the forms for the 2020 census without a question about citizenship.
What they do a few days later is come to a federal district court and say, we give up, game over.
Justice Department lawyers told a federal judge on Tuesday the fight was over.
Last today, it looks like the Trump administration basically had to admit it was all a ruse and wave the white flag.
Basically, we accept defeat.
We accept defeat, and Wilbur Ross issues a statement to that same effect.
I respect the Supreme Court, but strongly disagree with its ruling regarding my decision to reinstate a citizenship question on the 2020 census.
The Census Bureau has started the process of printing the decennial questionnaires without the question.
And then the next day, Wednesday, July 3rd.
The president is tweeting up a storm today.
President Trump tweets out that all of this is fake.
We're absolutely moving forward, as we must, because of the importance of the answer to this question.
And it's not clear what the fake is, because the reporting is a perfectly accurate reflection of what people in court and what a cabinet official in a statement said. But nonetheless, the president said it's fake.
That tweet prompted a scramble at the Justice Department.
They're now being instructed to go in an opposite direction and hunt up some kind of rationale nonetheless. So the tweet comes out, a federal judge in Maryland promptly sets up a telephone conference call on the record because he wants to know what the hell is going on here. And the Justice Department lawyers, to their credit, are perfectly candid about how confused they are. One of them, Joshua Gardner, says to the judge, what I told the court yesterday was absolutely my best understanding of the state of affairs, and apparently also the Commerce Department's state of affairs, because you probably saw Secretary Ross issue a statement very similar to what I told the court. The tweet this morning was the first I had heard of the president's position on this issue, just like the plaintiffs and Your Honor. I do not have a deeper understanding of what that means at this juncture, other than what the president has tweeted. But obviously, as you can imagine, I am doing my absolute best to figure out what's going on.
Chloe, this is not easier.
Exactly why, I presume, would be embarrassing if you're right. that they quit in protest because they don't like how this has been handled.
Yep, that's the problem.
So this is definitively not proceeding well for the Trump administration.
Yeah. Yes, that's right. Whatever Chief Justice Roberts expects, when at the end of June he ruled against the administration.